Live at Sun Life Stadium. Has it hit you now that you're down in Florida and what this team's been able to accomplish?
It's certainly a lot more realistic once you get to the stadium and, obviously media day and things are crazy. But the team's been really focused, done a really nice job of kind of keeping their minds on their business, and I think we're ready to go.
How do you keep from overanalyzing everything with the magnitude of this game? I mean, you have to watch the film over and over and, like, make sure you didn't miss one single thing.
Yeah, we definitely spend a lot more time second-guessing and kind of just making sure all the, I's are dotted and the T's are crossed. But I think more than anything, the players kind of, the way they practice and go about their business, give you a real good feel for whether you're on the right track or not. Okay. And you kind of let them lead the way and then build off those packages as you go forward.
Now, were you a grad assistant with Coach Kelly at Grand Valley State?
I was, back in 1987.
Give me some memories. What were the two of you like in 1987?
Well, we did a lot of, pooling our money and resources to make it, as GAs tend to have to do, and grew a really close bond and relationship way back in those days when we were hopefully up-and-coming coaches and finding our way in this business. And friendship has continued and mutual respect has continued, and here we are at the national championship game.
Now, when you're at Grand Valley State making $4,000 a year or what, and getting your master's.
Or less.
you can dream of this day, but it's really not realistic. So how satisfying is it for you guys to have reached this point in your careers?
Yeah, it's just, it's incredible if you stop for a minute and just kind of think about, all the things that each one of us have had to kind of go through to get to this point and get to this place. It's remarkable, and obviously, the good Lord has been good to both of us and put us in positions where we've got a great group of people to coach, a great university to work at, and here we are playing for it all.
Now, are you married with kids?
I am. I have my wife, Diane, and my son, Chance.
Okay. Now, how hard has it been? Because you've been at a lot of stops in your career, and that's part of coaching.
Sure.
But how hard is that to come home on a certain night and say, hey, we got to pack up and move again?
Yeah, you definitely need a partner as in your corner who loves the work that you do, shares in the work that you do. She's as involved with our football team as anybody. She loves it. She is very supportive in every avenue that we've ever been down in our professional life so far. And if you don't have that, it's very, very difficult. I'm lucky and blessed that I've got a partner that understands the business, understands that it may mean we may have to pick up and move to another place at some point in time, but hopefully we found a home for a very long time.